Hello, Namaste, Salaam Alaikum and Sat Sri Akal. Welcome back to another session with your War Chef at Warewar.com. Today, we're going to make another delicious okra dish, which is called Kadai Bhendi. Why do we call it Kadai Bhendi? See, typically this is cooked in a kadai where the items are tossed and cooked. But when you go and order dishes in a restaurant called kadai, you know, like kadai paneer or kadai vegetables or kadai, there's always two, three ingredients you will definitely see. That is nicely chopped onions and tomatoes tossed and nicely cooked to nicely saucy kind of texture. And they always often use kind of capsicum, that is bell pepper, that is green pepper, used in these dishes. To prepare this dish, we need okra. So what I did, I slightly deep-fried this cut okra. See, the reason why I cooked is in the kadai preparation, you don't take too long when you after you add, and you don't want that sticky kind of texture that okra can provide. So just deep fry your okra. But remember one thing, look at my okra, see how green they are. Don't fry your okra till they are crispy brown or anything. Just cook them to a consistency where they are nicely green in color, and that is when you bite into okra in your kadai bhendi, you get nice okra texture and taste. Some chopped tomatoes, I'm using some green and yellow. Curry leaf. Curry leaf is an optional, because if you go towards North India, in some of the kadai dishes you don't see curry leaves, but you know, I've seen a lot of people using curry leaves in kadai vegetables. Ginger garlic paste, sliced green chili, chopped onion, chopped coriander leaves, coriander seeds. Just put some coriander seeds and crush them. Cumin powder, coriander powder, cumin seeds, red chili powder, turmeric, salt, oil. In this preparation, I'm not using whole garam masala, so I'm going to use some garam masala powder. But if you want to use whole garam masala, you could use them. Add some oil into a hot pan. Add some cumin seeds, just like a half a teaspoon, and your crushed coriander seeds. And immediately, just after frying them for a few seconds, add chopped onion. I know I got a couple of complaints that I'm not showing the right quantity of the ingredients. I went and bought spoons here, measuring spoons. So we're going to try to use these spoons today. Just add a pinch of salt. This salt helps in bringing out the moisture from the onions and cook them good. For this preparation, you don't have to really brown the onions. So what we're going to do, we're going to add turmeric. Just 1/4 of turmeric. Don't add too much. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric. Nicely mix. 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. And this is tough. Make sure you cook it for a minute or so that the raw flavor of ginger garlic paste is gone. And then add some curry leaves, your sliced green chili, and again mix it. Now the green chilies, everything is sorted. At this time, what we do is, we add our diced tomatoes. I've taken 2 medium-sized tomatoes and then added to this. We will let these tomatoes cook. In the meanwhile, you can add 2 teaspoons of coriander powder and same 2 teaspoons of cumin powder and 1 teaspoon of chili powder. Okay, now I'm done with all these spices. Just mix it a little bit. See, one thing very good about all these kadai vegetables is the nice colors that you can see in the cooked vegetables. So once you let your tomatoes kind of get mashed up, not totally mashed up, kind of, you know, little bit cooked well. See, now these tomatoes are slightly mashed up and everything. You don't have to cook these tomatoes too much, and then add your capsicum bell pepper. Now just toss them a little bit. After you add your green and yellow pepper, you don't want it to cook it too much, because all you want is the nice peppery flavor get dissolved in this sauce little bit. Okay, you can see the nice green and yellow colors of these vegetables. You can sprinkle half of your coriander. Let this also get cooked really nice. See, one of my favorite kadai dishes are kadai paneer. Oh my god, if you cook it really right, the kadai paneer is one of the hottest dishes. Since your okra is all cooked, just add your okra, the fried okra to this. And now just mix it. And just cover it up and leave it like that in a medium flame for like 4-5 minutes and your okra dish will be ready. Ah, look at this. See, this is what it is. This particular vegetables, when you are cooking, you don't see so much of flavor. But when all these ingredients mix up, and that's when you see really nice flavor coming out. And if you want, you can top it off with slightly garam masala powder. Don't add too much. I don't like too much of garam masala powders in my food. And then just mix it up. Check this out. After a few minutes, oh my goodness. Okay, look at this. Your kadai vegetable is ready. Ah, yeah, see, that's one thing very good about after it is done, you will be able to toss your vegetables really up. Ah, wow, look at this, kadai vegetables. You know, after you cook for just like 5 minutes, you steam it so that nice infusion of flavors take place. Take a nice bowl and then slightly garnish it with coriander. Oh my god, I want to eat something with this. Okay, now let's taste this. See, I remember one thing, you know, when we were little kids in school, they used to say, you know, a lot of kids, I think so, somebody's parent must have told the kid doesn't eat okra. Hey, you eat okra, you will be good in your mathematics. See, that's how they make kids eat different kinds of vegetables. And wow, look at this. My goodness. Mmm. Look at the colors. My god. Nice green, yellow. Trust me, this is another great finger-licking lady finger dishes. And I want you to write back to me after you make this dish how it turned out. And remember that Vareva is all about inspiring others to cook. So please post your recipes and cooking tips so others may benefit from your great cooking.